February 2nd, 2020 will go down as one of the most exciting, record-breaking, and historic Super Bowl finals of all time. After a competitive start, in the third quarter, the Chiefs faded rapidly to look nothing like the same team that had made history in reclaiming the AFC's Lamar Hunt Trophy just 2 weeks prior. It was as if the entire team had been replaced with dummy lookalikes or drones. Despite all of the hype and hoopla surrounding this dream matchup, Super Bowl 54 was turning out to be a huge disappointment because the Chiefs were simply not in charge. Frontman Patrick Mahomes' passing was off repeatedly, and his lackluster grip on the ball led to an easy dispossession by Niners linebacker Fred Warner. I wonder if he'd been lulled into thinking that, for the third time in the playoffs and fourth overall that season, his team could ride a 10-plus point deficit right into the fourth quarter and still come back to win. But those were lesser contests. Yeah, one of them was the AFC Championship, but the Super Bowl is on a whole other level. You just can't take those kinds of risks when the stakes are this high, especially against a thoroughbred franchise like the 49ers. On the other side of the coin, the Niners smelled blood and, using their superior championship experience to their advantage, wasted no time in capitalizing on Mahomes' blunders. San Francisco did falter occasionally, but not in the way that one would expect. The stellar play was marred by two unsportsmanlike incidents, the push-off against Chiefs defenders by Niners receiver George Kittle, and the touchdown pass interference in the fourth quarter by Tarvarius Moore on Travis Kelce. The former offense was noticeably and unfortunately supported by 49ers head coach Kyle Shanahan, who was visibly infuriated by the rest rectifying call. Even sadder was the taboo play's endorsement by ESPN's Chris Berman and Randy Moss. Luckily, the refs called the infractions both times, unlike what happened to the Saints in the last two playoff seasons. Actually, the overall officiating was excellent, exemplified by the refs' eagle-eyed calls that were subsequently backed up by slow-mo replays. The Chiefs finally took over late in the game, with 7.5 minutes of pure magic led off by a bona fide conjurer, one who uses reality rather than illusion to create special, unforgettable moments. Mahomes brushed off his psychological bruises from the missed flows and fumbles of the past almost two quarters to deliver a true never-say-die MVP's performance. The Kingdom also benefited from a bit of luck, as the refs called Damian Williams' heroic finish a legal touchdown before realizing that, due to the absence of goal line cams, that decision would turn out to be irreversible. It could just as easily have gone San Francisco's way. We'll never know. So as it turns out, Super Bowl 54 did live up to its billing, Kansas City storming to victory via some record-breaking, history-making feats. One, they're the first team in Super Bowl history to come back from three double-digit playoff deficits and win the big prize. Two, after making history during the 2018-19 season to become the youngest ever league MVP, Patrick Mahomes did one better this season to become the youngest ever Super Bowl MVP and the youngest ever Super Bowl champion quarterback. On a lighter note, Mahomes' constant touchdown partner Travis Kelce changed his post-game interview mantra from, "You've got to fight for your right to party," after winning the AFC Championship, to, "You've got to fight for your right to Lombardi," after the Super Bowl, gyrating in true Lombardi style. Super Bowl 54 was the culmination of a season during which the Chiefs Nation restamped its authority as a marquee franchise of the NFL. They ended 50 long years of bitter drought in Kansas City, in no small part due to the superhuman exploits of their Mahomes Messiah. That's all for now, guys. Donna. Thanks for watching this story from the Donna's Diary documentary series. Similar stories are available from the related videos section. See description below and from your video feed on the far right. Please join me again in 2 months for the next diary entry. Did you enjoy this post? Then please click the like button and add a comment below this video. To make sure that you never miss one of my vlog posts, click the subscribe button below and then click the little bell in order to be notified whenever I post a new video. Please see the next slide for a list of my pages and channels.